Hello everyone, I am Stavri Chrysostomou. I am a clinical dietitian and nutritionist. I work as an assistant professor at the Department of Life Sciences at the Program of Nutrition and Dietetics at European University Cyprus. First of all, I would like to welcome you all at European University Cyprus and express my best wishes for the new academic year. I hope that by the end of my presentation today, I will manage to convince you to eat well if you want to stay well and to help you adapting some healthy eating behaviors for your health and wellness during your student life. Now, which are the aims of my presentation today? First of all, I would like to show you the importance and the meaning of healthy eating. And secondly, I would like to show you some simple and sustainable healthy eating behaviors that you can develop as a student. As we know, you are all new students, so this life, academic life, is going to be a new life for all of you. You will now be in a university, you will now meet a new level of education, you will meet new people, you're going to make new friends, you're going to have a new lifestyle. And if you are students coming from different parts of the world or even from different parts of Cyprus, then you will probably be moving in a new house, meaning that you will be responsible for the housing, such as cleaning the house, making the shopping for your house, and cooking, preparing the food for yourself. So if you were here with me right now, I would be interested in asking you some questions. One of these questions could be this one. Who is going to prepare, who is going to cook the food for you during your student life? I expect that the most popular answer will be this one. There are too many fast food, there are too many takeaway restaurants in Nicosia, there is also a restaurant and a cafeteria in a campus, so you will probably buy something from there. A second question that could be arise from the first one is this one. Do you think that this type of food, this fast food, this takeaway food is bad for you? If you ask my opinion as a specialist, as a nutritionist, and since I always have in mind the beneficial effect of healthy eating, I would say that no, this type of food is not bad for you. Most of these restaurants, they do offer some homemade food. They do include some healthy options within their menus. So if you have a basic knowledge in nutrition, you will be able to eat healthy. But from the other part, I would say that yes, this type of food is bad for you. And I will now explain the reasons of my answer. First of all, have you ever thought about the cost of buying food from outside? It's not that we eat once a week or twice a week, we eat every day. And based on the national guidelines for healthy eating, we should be eating at least 4 to 6 meals a day. So do you think, is this going to be affordable for you? Secondly, what about the limited variety? Typically, this type of food include the same food, pizzas, burgers, sandwiches. So isn't it going to be boring for you one day if you have the same food for every week or even for every day? What about your food preferences? If you are international students, definitely your food preferences will be different. Our food preferences are also different, and they are based on our culture, on our religion, on our country. So will you find the food you prefer here in Cyprus? And also, what about the effect of this type of food on your health? In my opinion, this is the most important factor. In nutrition, in my science, we have many nutrients. Some of them we call them good nutrients, and some other we call them bad nutrients. Based on the research, good nutrients are associated with beneficial effect on our health. And these good nutrients include some types of proteins, carbohydrates, fats, minerals, vitamins, some antioxidants, some polyphenols. From the other, we have the bad nutrients that are associated with an increased risk of developing some chronic diseases. These bad nutrients include some types of fats, some types of carbohydrates, some additives, some chemical additives, and it is recommended to eliminate their consumption. Usually, this type of food, fast food and takeaway food, includes high amounts of these bad nutrients. So why should we be eating healthy? What are the reasons for healthy eating? First of all, we want to eat healthy because we want to maintain a healthy body weight. And how can you know, how can I know that my body weight is healthy? There is an index, we call it body mass index, which can be easily calculated if you divide your body weight with your body height. And if the values are within the range of 18.5 and 25, that means that your body weight is healthy, is normal, is ideal. This ideal body weight, this normal body weight, is associated with better health. This normal body weight will give you a nice body shape, will make you feel happier, and will increase your energy and your confidence. We can see from the photo here that someone is gaining weight. Usually, but definitely not always, students gain weight during their academic life. We are not pretty sure about the reasons of this weight gaining, but if your initial body weight, if your body weight at the beginning of your academic life is normal, then definitely we want to avoid this weight gaining, because this weight gaining will bring you some problems related to your health. Other reasons for healthy eating. Healthy diet and nutritious diet is associated with a stronger immune system. A healthy diet ensures that your immune system will function optimally. As I said before, we have some good nutrients that are associated with this beneficial effect on our immune system. A healthy diet also makes our immune system work better. A healthy diet can make our immune system stronger. So if you eat healthy, then the risk of developing some diseases, the risk of getting sick, the risk of developing some infections, the risk of developing oxidative stress and inflammation will be much lower compared to unhealthy eating. As I said before, we have some good nutrients. These good nutrients are associated with a stronger immune system. These good nutrients can boost our immune system, can regulate our immune system, so they can make it stronger and the risk of getting diseases will be much lower. And if we want to stay up to date with the latest, we cannot ignore that we are now in the midst of a pandemic, of COVID-19 pandemic. Very, very recent studies have shown that a healthy diet is associated with a lower risk of getting infected by COVID-19. In particular, these studies have shown that particular specific micronutrients such as the zinc, iron, and some antioxidant vitamins such as vitamin A, vitamin C, and vitamin E are associated with this lower risk of getting infected by COVID-19. Also, there are a few studies that showed that if you eat healthy and you're already infected by COVID-19, then the treatment will be much effective. Other reasons for healthy eating. If you eat healthy, then the risk of developing some non-communicable diseases in the future, such as diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, renal disease, and several types of cancer will be much lower. As we can see from the graph here, a previous study have tried to examine the effect of specific food items on the risk of developing chronic diseases. And we can see that some food items such as butter, sauce, and red meat, that we call them unhealthy because they contain some nutrients that we called them before bad nutrients, the consumption of these food items is associated with an increased risk of developing chronic diseases, whereas other healthier options such as whole grain bread, raw vegetables, and coffee, which we call them healthy options, they are associated with a lower risk of developing such diseases. Other reasons for healthy eating. If you eat healthy, you're going to sleep better. If you eat healthy, you're going to sleep more, and the quality of your sleep will be much better. This optimized sleep is associated with better health, better hormonal function, is associated with an ideal body weight. The research showed that people who sleep better, they also maintain a healthy body weight, and this optimized sleep is associated with improved focus and productivity, which is mainly very important for you as a student. Other reasons for healthy eating. If you eat healthy, you will have a better mental health. And why do I mention this to you, to students right now? Because previous epidemiological studies have shown that many students are suffering from mental disorders such as depression, anxiety, stress, and this is something that we should be worried about. In particular, we can see from the graphs here that about 1 in 4 college students suffer from mental disorders. Also, we can see from the other graph that every academic year, the number of students seeking mental health support is being increased. So, specific food items and specific eating behaviors have a beneficial effect on our mental health. We can see here that it is recommended to consume whole grain products such as whole grain bread, brown rice, brown pasta. It is recommended to eat fruits and vegetables during a day, to drink plenty of water, to eat a variety of foods, to include protein in your diet, to eat regularly during a day, and it is also recommended to avoid some other unhealthy options, such as it is recommended to avoid the consumption of saturated fat and hydrogenated fat, which is the bad type of fat that we want to avoid and we want to eliminate, because this type of fat is associated with an increased risk of developing chronic diseases such as cardiometabolic diseases, mental disorders, and many others. It is also recommended to avoid alcohol consumption, and it is also recommended to avoid and eliminate the consumption of refined products and other food items that contain high amounts of sugar. Also, something that I forgot to mention is that it is recommended to include omega-3 fatty acid in your diet. This fatty acid is a good type of fat that can be found in oily fishes, in seafood, and some plant-based products. And this type of fat is associated with better health. It's associated with better cardiometabolic health, better mental health. That's why it is recommended to include them in our diet on a daily basis. Other reasons for healthy eating. A healthy diet is associated with a better cognitive performance. If you eat better, you're gonna have a better alertness, better memory, better attention, and your ability in solving problems will be much better. A previous study published by the World Health Organization a few years ago showed that students who followed a healthy diet had a much higher performance in language, in maths, and their overall grading was much higher compared to students that had a fair diet or an unhealthy diet. So there are several pathways, direct and indirect, that links healthy diet with academic achievement. If you eat healthy, you will be a better learner and you will have higher academic grades. Unhealthy eating and insufficient food intake is associated with lower grades, with repeating a grade, and decreased focus and productivity among students. So what are the core messages up to now? Eat healthy if you want to stay healthy. You are what you eat. We completely agree with this, but remember, you make the choices. Plan your meals and make them healthier. And I will now show you some simple and sustainable healthy eating behaviors that you can develop as a student. First of all, do not skip meals. Eat at least 4 to 6 meals a day. This will keep your stomach full. This will delay the hunger. This will help you control your overall eating, and it will help you maintaining your body weight. Ensure that the gap between two subsequent meals is not more than 4 hours. Never skip breakfast. Based on the research, breakfast is the most important meal of the day. A healthy breakfast can jumpstart your metabolism. Avoid eating late at night. Eat during a day. Eat when you are more active. Fast for at least 14 to 16 hours. Based on the research, this fasting, if you relax your digestive system for a few hours on a daily basis, this will help you regulating your body weight. Also, vary your meals. No single food contains all the nutrients that your body needs. There is only an exception on this, and this is the breastfeeding period during the infancy. All the other periods in life require us to have a variety of food in our diet. Remember, if you are on a diet, if you follow a healthy diet, you do not need to eliminate and exclude any food group from your diet, but rather you should choose the healthiest option from each food group, from each food category. We can see from the slide here that we have 5 different food groups. We should include them all in our diet. We cannot exclude any food group because we need them all. We can see the first group, the starchy group. This is our energy supplier. We need to have it in our diet. Fruits and vegetables. This is a good source of vitamins, minerals, antioxidants. They keep us healthy, so we need to have it in our diet. Dairy products. This is a good source of calcium, which is important for our bone health. So we need to have dairy products in our diet. What about proteins? They help our muscle to grow and repair, so we need to include proteins in our diet. And what about the fat? They protect our organs. We need to have them. But if your body weight is not normal, if you're obese or overweight, then you should be careful on the amount of fat that you consume. Other tip, ensure that you include high quality proteins and different types of proteins in your diet. Proteins is not only included in meat. Meat is a good source of protein. And be aware, remember that when we eat chicken or pork, remove the visible fat. That fat is the animal fat. It's a bad type of fat that we want to avoid. Fish is also a good source of protein. It contains high quality protein, and oily fish prefer choose the oily fishes because they are also a good source of omega-3 fatty acids, the good type of fat that we want to emphasize. We want to encourage its consumption because it is associated with better health. Dairy products, this is a good source of protein. Choose the low-fat dairy products. Legumes, this is a good source of protein and fibers as well. Nuts and seeds, good source of protein, fibers, and the good type of fat, the unsaturated fatty acids that we want to include them in our diet. Nuts and seeds is also a good choice as a snack. What about the carbohydrates, our energy suppliers? We also have the good types and the bad types here. We encourage you to emphasize the consumption of good type and avoid, eliminate the consumption of bad types. Good types of carbohydrates include fruits, vegetables, legumes, nuts, seeds, whole grain products such as whole grain bread, brown rice, brown pasta, and tubers, potatoes, that are mainly cooked on the grill or boiled. From the other part, we have the bad types of carbohydrates such as sugary drinks, white bread, refined products, white rice, white pasta, pastries, cookies, cakes, ice creams, candies, chocolates, and fresh fries. What about the fat? The fat is a nutrient that gives us energy. It gives us much more energy compared with the energy that is given by protein and carbohydrates. However, we need to have it in our diet. We have two types of fat. The good types, the unsaturated fatty acids, which is mainly found in fishes, in oily fishes, in seafood and plant-based products. And we also have the bad types, the saturated fatty acids, which are mainly found in animal products. We should encourage, and it is recommended, to emphasize the consumption of good types and eliminate, avoid the consumption of bad types. At this point here, I have a short presentation that I would like you to watch about it, and it explains with a very nice way the different types of fat in our diet. The meaning and the message of this video is that we should eat less fat if we want to live a healthier life. Let's see the video and we will be back in a minute. So, all we said up to now is included, is in concentrated into this pyramid. If you search the bibliography, you can find many types of pyramid. You can find the Mediterranean pyramid, you can find the healthy eating pyramid. You also, several countries have developed their own pyramids based on their food-based guidelines. However, the meaning of these pyramids is the same. At the bottom, you can see food items that it is recommended to include them on a daily basis, regularly, in higher amounts. And as we move from the bottom to the top, the frequency and the amount of consumption is being decreased. At the top, you can find some food products that it is recommended to use them sparingly because they contain what we called before these bad nutrients that are associated with many chronic diseases. For example, we can see that at the top here, there is, you can see the red meat and butter that contain high amounts of the bad type of fat, the saturated and the hydrogenated fatty acids. And we can also see the white rice, white bread, white pasta, refined products and cakes that contain high amounts of sugar, and it's also recommended to avoid their consumption. It is also recommended to limit sugar intake. Be careful, there are hidden sugar in many processed foods and drinks. For example, a small bottle of Coke contains 16 teaspoons of sugar. Also, a can of Red Bull contains about 13 teaspoons of sugar. Be aware that 1 teaspoon of sugar gives you about 20 to 25 calories. So, can you calculate the amount of calories that you can get by just drinking a small bottle of Coke or a can of Red Bull? What about alcohol consumption? Based on the research, moderate alcohol consumption is recommended for better cardiometabolic health. We completely agree with this recommendation, but also the recommendation says that if you have never drunk alcohol before, then you are allowed not to use this recommendation. So if you have never drunk alcohol before in your life, it is perfectly okay with us not to drink it, not to try it. Alcohol is something that gives you too much energy but zero nutritional value. So remember, don't drink alcohol if you have never drunk before in your life. Don't drink if you are driving. Don't drink alcohol if you are taking any medicines that might interact with alcohol. And don't drink if you cannot control the amount of your drinking. A few more tips related to your eating behaviors. First of all, Prepare your own meals. Avoid buying food from outside. If you prepare your own meals, you will eat healthier, you will eat fewer calories, and you will manage to maintain your body weight. You make the options. So prefer, choose the healthier options and avoid, eliminate other unhealthy options such as fried food, fried potatoes, fried meat. Read the labels. It is very important for you to be aware of what you are eating, to know what you are eating. Focus on how you feel after you're eating. The healthier the food you eat, the better you will feel after your meal. And take this as a strong motivation. Try for a day to eat healthy and write down your feelings, and try for the next day to do exactly the opposite. Try to eat unhealthy and write down your feelings again. Believe me, between these 2 days, you will see the difference. Drink plenty of water. Drink at least 8 cups of water a day. Water helps your body to throw away waste products and toxins. If you must eat fast food, do it wisely. Remember, you make the choices, so you can avoid, you can eliminate the consumption of fried potatoes, fried food, and prefer some other healthier options. Keep healthy snacks on hand. There are some healthy snacks such as fruits, vegetables, crackers, rice cakes, low-fat yogurt, cottage cheese that you can easily carry them with you at the campus, at the university. If you need to lose weight, do it sensibly. Do not exaggerate. Do not starve. Starvation is harmful. Follow a healthy diet, follow a balanced diet, and exercise your body. Enjoy your food and savor it. Before I end this presentation, I encourage you to watch the next video where a few of our postgraduate students will show you some great cooking tips. Actually, they will advise you on how to prepare some student-friendly meals that are not only healthy, but are also very delicious. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for your attention, and have a healthy start to the new semester.
Hello. You are currently in your student dorm and you are wondering, what should I eat? The obvious choice is something quick and probably unhealthy. But did you know healthy food can be quick and tasty as well? My name is Konstantinos, and with my course mate Olga and Maggie, we will present you healthy meal ideas for students. As you know, breakfast is often called the most important meal of the day. The reason it's so important is that it breaks the overnight fasting period, it replenishes glucose intake and boosts your energy levels. For the breakfast number one, we will be making overnight oats with banana and cocoa. For this recipe, we will need 14 grams oats, 1 teaspoon chia seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of cocoa, 1/2 banana, and we add milk of our choice or just water. or 60 ml are enough. At the end, we close the base, mix it all, and we leave it in the fridge for tomorrow. Take it out the next day and just enjoy. For the eggs and avocado lovers, here a suggestion for you. You will just need 1 large egg, 1 slice of whole wheat bread, 1/4 of avocado, 4 sliced cherry tomatoes, and 1/4 of onion, 1 teaspoon of olive oil, and some lime juice. For the preparation, we will hard boil an egg for 5 minutes, then toast the bread. Mix the guacamole with cherry tomatoes and onion. Then spread it on the top of the bread. Put the egg on the top of the guacamole. Just slice it. And voila, here's an easy, filling and tasty breakfast.
Hello, I'm Olga, and it's time for lunch. Let's prepare a healthy and delicious dish. What about chickpeas with tuna and pita bread? It's an alternative way to eat your legumes and an easy and easily quickly prepare lunch that you can have with you everywhere. Chickpeas are high in protein and can be an excellent replacement for meat in vegan and vegetarian diets. Also, they contain several vitamins and minerals, which are essential for a healthy diet. Let's see the ingredients for this tasty recipe. For the stuffing, you will need 60 grams of canned drained tuna in water, 3 tablespoons of corn, 1/2 cup of boiled chickpeas, 2 tablespoons of parsley or coriander, 1 small fresh onion, and 1 diced cucumber. Also, you will need 1 grated carrot, 1/2 a bell pepper of your choice, 1 pinch of salt and pepper, and 2 teaspoons of olive oil. Next, we mix all the ingredients together in a bowl, and then we stuff our pita bread with the ingredients. We can toss the pita if we want. Enjoy it! Snacks can be the tricky part in one's diet because even though you can be very organized during the whole day with all your meals, during your snack time you might slip up and cheat. That means you might overeat and consume some excessive calories. For the snacks, I've prepared 2 different recipes, one savory and one sweet. For the first recipe, I will be doing a no-bake energy bowls. I will use 100 grams of oats, 2 tablespoons of peanut butter, 2 tablespoons of honey, 25 grams of chocolate chips, and 25 grams of cranberries. I'll start the recipe by adding the oats
the peanut butter. And the honey. And then I'll start mixing it gently. For this recipe, you will need to get your hands dirty, so you need to get them involved in the whole process. As you can see, my hands got really dirty, so I had to go wash them. So moving on, we will be needing to separate the mixture and divide it into another bowl. In one of the bowls, I will be using the cranberries. And in the other one, the chocolate chips. So in this step, you will have to get your hands dirty again and mix it all together. And then continue by forming them into balls. I'll be forming bowls of approximately 20 grams each. As you see, the mixture can be really tough sometimes, but it's sticky, so it can form balls. And here are the energy balls. If you're not much of a sweet tooth yourself, this is a recipe you will enjoy. Today I will be preparing muffins with Parmesan cheese, corn, smoked turkey, and rosemary. The ingredients I will be using are 65 grams of plain flour, 65 grams of crushed oats, half a teaspoon baking powder, half a teaspoon paprika, and 100 milliliters of milk, 1.5 tablespoons olive oil, 1 egg, a slice of smoked turkey, 1/2 teaspoon rosemary, and 2 tablespoons Parmesan cheese. Now moving on to the procedure method. First things first, preheat your oven at 200 degrees Celsius. Then mix all your dry ingredients together into a large bowl. Now the mixture became homogenized and now is ready to be put into the tray in order to make the muffins. Now I'm gonna move it on the side and bring the muffin tray in front of me. And I'll be doing a trick where I put the mixture into the tray. Continue doing this step until you fill all the pockets. And now they're ready. The only step left is to grate some Parmesan cheese on top of each one of them, in order to give them this really nice crispy texture. And now we're ready to put them into the oven. And now, this is the completed version of the muffins. They're super tasty, they're easy to carry and take with you anywhere, and they're only 75 calories each. Dinner is a very important meal, and we mustn't avoid it. Eating dinner for at least 3 hours before going to bed can be beneficial for your digestion process. Today, we'll be preparing chicken with honey mustard sauce, accompanied with vegetable skewers and basmati rice. We'll start off with the skewers. Firstly, we will need one onion, one zucchini, and one bell pepper, 6 cherry tomatoes, some olive oil, oregano, sea salt, and pepper. We will mix all our vegetables together. Some lemon juice. Cherry tomatoes. Salt. Pepper, tablespoon of olive oil, and some oregano to give it a little bit of a great taste. And mix the vegetables together. Now, I will be using a wooden stick and pierce through the vegetables. I'll try doing it in order. And then grill them for about 20 minutes in about 180 degrees Celsius. And then we continue with the chicken. Now we're going to do the honey mustard sauce. We're going to explain how I did it. So I have used 1 tablespoon of mustard, yellow mustard preferably, 2 teaspoons of honey, some salt, and half an orange, and a little bit of lime juice. And for the chicken, I'll be using 1 chicken breast, which I've already marinated with a little bit of salt and pepper. And now I'm gonna mix it with the honey mustard orange sauce. Now that I've mixed the chicken with the sauce, I'll be adding 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Now we're ready to add it into the pan. I prefer non-stick pans because otherwise it would make a mess. And just put it in the pan. Spread it out a little bit and then heat it up for about 20 to 30 minutes. Remember, you still have the vegetable skewers in the oven, 20 minutes. And then we're about to serve our dish. Here is the honey mustard chicken with the basmati rice and the vegetable skewers. So this is our dish. Bon appetit.